Yes, eye movement is tracked with MoCam protocol correctly. It's just pixel for us, it's just pixel tracking, so yes.
How easy is it to match up the MoCam performance of someone and then add it to, say, the voice of some famous Hollywood person who's going on top of that? Do you capture facial movements for that instance, or is it more you take the audio work first and then get them to match?
Well, we can go several ways. We can record just the body here, and then we ship the helmet that you saw in, let's say, in LA, and then we can record using a real well-known actor. We can then record stuff like that. He'll have a reference, you know, a time reference in front of him. It's ADR. It's wow. He's gonna see all the performances going, and he's gonna need time with it. But again, you know, we try to do everything at the same time as possible. And that was used for Far Cry 3. Everything was captured at the same time.
There was no tracking for animals, for example.
Animals? We didn't do. Did we do animals yet?
We did some tests, but often if you take a dog, the dog after 5 minutes is gonna do this or try to rub it off. So what you need to do when you do this, you need to train, you need to work in advance like 3 months, and then they put like some straps on the dog, and then for a month they make him walk with that. Then after the lab markers and so on and so on. So right now we at Ubisoft we have a lot of animators so that can do it. So it's not worth it passing 3 months on the dog. To do this, or either bring a horse here and have someone with a shovel to follow the horse. So right now, no, we didn't do any animals in here. We did kids. Kids is also really hard because them, if you do scripted event and you say, okay, now I want your intention, I want you to feel sad, and he's gonna be sad. Next time you can say, now can you do it, but turn this way, then he does it. But the third time, the game is boring, so now can I do something else? Can I play with that gun? Can I sit on the bed? Can I play that car? So, but that's the kind of thing that, so we did kids, but this again, we bring the parents in so that they feel at ease. Often we'll bring them a day or two in advance so that they can at least see what they'll do. And often, well, the kids, for us, it's even like a bonus because you tell the kids, well, you're gonna play this character and you show him the pictures. And we say, don't tell your friends because it's secret to do the game. Oh yeah, don't worry, I won't tell a thing. And you see it in his eyes. First thing he's going to do is tell his friends, don't say it, but I'm playing this character. So it's funny to see that. Yeah,
how about non-human characters? I mean, if you have some of your mini-games.
Yeah, well,
patience and stuff.
Yeah, like we don't do performance capture for everything. Sometimes, you know, the action will be too hard to capture. It will be even in the end, not feasible for us to capture it. And also, so we have, you know, a lot of animators that does that kind of stuff.
But everything that's props, like before, like we said, oh, the car is not important, we just need a box. But now, we are doing real-time tests so that before that, we load the game team will send us the car, we'll put it in the we'll put it in Motion Builder, and then we'll have the real actor going in the volume, and we'll put the fake car. We'll say, put your hand on the roof, and then the hand is really offset, then we'll adjust the car so that when the actor will go in, it's gonna take the door, it's gonna be a one-on-one. So the same thing with everything that we can do it, we'll do that because we know that the actor will have good references and it's gonna give better animation. So another service that Mark has developed with his team is a way to extract the rotation like from the markers to create a skeleton. So what we do is, when I said to you that the guy was doing the chicken dance, well, the chicken dance for us is super important because we call it the ROM, is the range of movement. Is because when they do all of this, then we get the rotation and we do all of that, and then we put this kind of a fake character, and then it's gonna give us the proper place and placement of the joint. And his tool, what it does is it extract that, creates a skeleton and send it to the project. So the project have a one-on-one of the actor that was in a suit. So if he's 3'2", then they will have a skeleton that's 3'2". So if they try to put this on an orc that's 12 feet, then well, you'll have a problem. You have the orc with his arm like that. So that's why his stuff, the tool he created was gaining some time and helping the production to have better animation, because if you have a one-on-one and when he puts his hand, he doesn't have the elbow like this or the elbow like that, well, it's just because we have the proper rotation. So that's a service we offer to the game team. They have the skeleton, they build their character, and then they put it together and they see, oh yeah, it fits, or we'll adjust ours. And so that's really where we're going, to match as possible what we're happening here so that they gain the best of the performance capture. But there's still some old games that's been in development, so that they're still stuck with, oh, we build one character and they keep it. But right now, all the new games, everything, is they're really aiming to that. But that's a big change, because if you do this, changing the skeleton, then you need to go back to modeling, you need to go back to creating the character, so it's a big impact on production. That's a new way of thinking also. So this gives good results for animation.
Do you have enough projects to use the studio full time?
Yes.
Yeah, I could open a night shift and a weekend shift. Last year, to give you an example, we were shooting like 3 days, 1 week, 4 days the other week, and we did that from, let's say, January to March. And then from March to October, we were shooting 4 days, and after that was 5 days all the time. So last year, we did 160 shoots. And the year before was 110, and before 80, and the first year 30. And this year is going to be, we know we're going to do 200 shoot. And right now we're building a second mocap volume at the other place that's going to be smaller, so that the small stuff like we saw today could be shot in a smaller room to give this place to another team that wants to do bigger stuff. So it's crazy how the demand. Right now my biggest problem is refusing customer. I have too much customer that wants to come here. So that's my problem. So for me, that's my best problem. So I'm a nappy guy.
Also, more shoot days mean a lot of tracking, to a lot of bus processing the data. So 1 day of shoot might represent 5 days of work later on for tracking the data and putting it into the game engine. So of course, if we shoot every day, that means we need an army of guys behind it to treat that data. So,
or a good dev team. No. And that's why I'm wearing.
So yeah, this is where Forge comes into play a bit. That helps out a few things. So.
You have other questions? Yes?
What percentage of the game's animations are mocap versus keyframe? Like roughly?
Oh, that's a good question. Do you know that too?
Well, character-wise, I would say out of, let's say, 10 games, I would say 9 of them are all mocap.
But for Far Cry?
For Far Cry, then I would say almost everything is mocap. Okay. Almost. Well, just the animals and Chopper or other things, but I would say it's almost.
The characters are entirely.
Could ask the guy on the other side, but I would say we do everything. And I would say it's almost all the games like right now are all like that. So almost, I would say 90% of that stuff. We don't do underwater mocap so far, skydiving, we're not there yet. And seriously, there's a lot of like SWAT move to go down a building and jump in. Us here, the arm limitation is the ceiling, and that's why eventually we hope that we'll be able to move to a bigger place. But even this is only 10% of your move. So is it worth it to have a bigger building when you can do everything else? So sometimes you have keyframers that will do this, and you won't see a thing in the action with camera movement. So that's good.
In that studio, can you record right up to the ceiling?
We can record just, there were like some black drapes cutting the neons, yeah. The lighting, and that's 14 feet, around 14 and 7 inch, or almost 15 feet.
I don't know, meters.
Yeah, well, almost 3.5 meters, I would say, that we're able to get.
Okay.
So, yeah, really close to the ceiling is just this from the pipes.
Yeah.
So, and just in the center, because you had like 3 rectangles. So the white one was like the safe zone. When you get there, we lose the actor. Then that's the big volume where we get everything. But to do high stuff, we get in the smaller zone, which is maybe this side. So that's where we put the scaffolding and the big action when it happens. So yes.
Given that the data needs to be input into a game engine and rendered in real time and whatnot, how does what you do, the performance capture you do for a game, compare to the likes of, say, Hollywood?
Quality side pretty out there. Like I said, the team that we have here, it's all guys that have been doing mocap for a long time, so it's really top notch guys. And we do have a good equipment, good techniques and everything. So yeah, pretty there.
Can you say that what you do is perhaps offer more than what a Hollywood film does?
I would say pretty similar, yeah.
Okay.
Very, if not better. But no, yeah, these guys are good too, so I would say we're.
And like Mark said earlier, we're lucky we're 20 people here, but we're 20 people from around the world. So we have people from, like I said earlier, from Sweden, we have people from the States, we have people from Vancouver. And the worst is not from all Ubisoft, so it's some of them are all people from, he's from another company before, I'm from another company. So now it's funny because mocap is starting to get older, so people now are in the industry for a while, they have all their experience. And here it's like if everybody left everywhere and we all got together, and now we're sharing what we know and together. So now we're, yeah, I did this there, I work on Tron doing the facial stuff, we have three guys that work on Tron, and so it's like, okay, cool, so now bring it in. So, and now we're putting this there. So the past 2 years for us is technology, we've been doing like that.
Yeah.
The shoots are going like this.
We had a chance, like, a lot of us is from actually from Kidara, which is the original company behind the software that deals with mocap and motion builder. So we have the developer of motion builder working for us. We both worked for that company before, so we know the software really well. And we were in consultation team, so we traveled the world, we worked with all the major studios. So we saw what was the good things and the bad things, so we kind of explored that. So that's what I'm saying.
And we're super happy. Me, seriously, right now you would tell me where you would want to go to another project? Nowhere. I'm in the best place right now. I work with the best people. We have a great team. Everybody is really good working. And but now, even at Ubisoft, mocap, like 5 years ago, you wanted to do mocap. Mocap is you get chunky data. Now everybody wants to do it with us, but not because technically, yes, technically we're there, but also because we're open, because sometimes project will say, oh, I want to do this. And we're like, oh my God, how will we do this? Then we sit down with them, then we find it. And if we don't know, we'll go and get the information and we'll make it happen. So our goal is to be there for the project so that we do what they want and that we're able to get the best data possible. So we believe in that.
All the recording going on, how much data per second we are talking? How many megabytes or terabytes?
Too much. Too much. So.
Well, the data itself, the markers data itself, it's not too good. But you know, we have video live, HD video reference, we have a lot of stuff going on. So we have a batch farm to process all this. We have a bunch of computers that just change that process. I couldn't tell you number,
there's not enough place in your book to take notes for the that size. It's intense, it's really intense, and we do a lot of backups to be sure that. So after a month, everything is full, so we need to have a super big backup.